Hello, welcome to this quick video on an introduction to Ansible. So we are going to get started. This is a getting started with Ansible video. So we're going to start literally at the very beginning and start the journey. And there's going to be a whole series of videos here where I'm going to talk to you about Ansible. So my name is Roger Perkin. I am a network DevOps engineer based in the UK. And for the next few videos, I'm going to take you on a journey from nothing until Ansible expert, so you can know everything there is to know about Ansible. So first of all, what is Ansible? I'm going to point you to a quick blog post on my website here, rogerperkin.co.uk. Ansible is basically an open source automation platform, which was purchased by Red Hat in October 2015 and is used heavily by the server admin community, and now very popular with the network automation community, which is myself. So that's what is Ansible, and I'm going to give you a brief introduction here on getting started. Now, very simply, this is what something I wish I knew when I started to learn Ansible and was never explained to me. So Ansible is just software. So it's open source software which you can install. Now, let's get my pen here. But what you need to do is install. Hold on. Pen. Okay, so you have what you call your control node here. So this is your control node, and this is where you install Ansible. So Ansible sits on here. Now this literally can be a laptop or any small device. So this is currently, I have this running on my laptop, but it does have to be Linux. Okay, so that has to be Linux to install the Ansible software. Now, it's very easy to install. In the next video, I will be installing Ansible onto a control node so we can then perform some automation tasks. But it has to be Linux. Now, what if you are a Windows man? So if you are running on Windows and you want to use Ansible, then you have to use something which is called WSL, Windows Subsystem for Linux. And that will enable you to run a subsystem within Windows, which is actually Linux under the hood. And then you can install Ansible that way. So that's the basic scenario. But we're going to install this on Ubuntu in the next video. So you install Ansible on your control node. And then whatever you want to automate, all you need is SSH connectivity to those devices. Now, these devices, this can be a server, this could be AWS, this could be something in Azure, or this could be a Cisco router. Yep. So all you need here is connectivity between your Ansible control node and your target device, and all you need to have is SSH access to that device. So if you can SSH to the device, then you are able to use Ansible to perform that automation task. So once you've installed Ansible, there are literally a few things you need to do to get it up and running. So let's move that out of the way. And we'll just go through the basics you need to get Ansible running. So we now have our Ansible control node here. This is my Ansible control node. In our example, this is going to be Ubuntu, but it does, like I said, need to be a Linux box. And then within your Ansible installation, you just have to define your inventory. Now, this is sometimes called the host file. Or a host file. Now, within the host file, you define the devices that you want to automate. So these can either be listed by IP address. So you can literally put the IP address in your host file that you want to connect to. Or you put the actual server name. Or you can actually define an IP address and then you put Ansible host and then you can give it a name. Now let me just bring up a sample Ansible host file so you can see it. Just a minute. Okay, so let's just bring another web page then. I'll pop the links to this in the description of the video. But this is an example of an Ansible inventory file. And you can see here that you either define the Ansible host by its name or its IP address here. Or as I said before, you can actually put a name in and then you can put the keyword Ansible host and then specify an IP address. So if you don't have DNS resolving to the device, and then these are called groups. So you define a group name with the square brackets. So in this example, I've got a group called routers and this is a group called switches. And then within that group, you then define the devices that you want to put in that group. And then when you write your Ansible playbook, you reference the group. So if you reference the routers group within the playbook, it will then target all the devices within that group. So we'll get on to playbooks in a minute, but that is the basics of the Ansible inventory file. And I'm just going to explain a few other terms for Ansible in our sort of getting started series, and then in later videos we'll expand on those. So what we have with Ansible are a few things. Now the basic free open source version of Ansible is currently referred to as Ansible Core. So this is free, this is open source. You can install this and run Ansible on the command line only. So this is a command line tool that you install and you can do all the functionality of Ansible. If you want a GUI version, you need to get something called the Ansible Automation Platform. Now the Ansible Automation Platform is a subscription service from Red Hat, which you then can have a GUI front end, which then connects into, so you also install Ansible Core under the hood. So everything, the actual configuration or the tasks are being done by Ansible Core, but the Ansible Automation Platform is driving this. Now, Ansible Automation Platform is obviously, that's money, so you have to pay for that. But the benefits of Ansible Automation Platform is that you get an API. So with the API, you can then get drive your automation tasks through more programmatic ways through the API. You've also got security on here, so you've got a lot more control. So you can give access to certain groups of people, you can hide passwords, you can only allow certain people to run certain playbooks. There is logging, so that's the main thing with here. So you actually got a full audit trail of playbooks that have been run. There is a whole host of features available with Ansible Automation Platform. Let me just bring up a page so you can see that. I'm just going to drag in another page on my site here. So we've got another one here. So what is the Ansible Automation Platform? Now, the Ansible Automation Platform is the new version of Ansible Tower. So you may have heard the words Ansible Tower. So Ansible Tower is basically the previous incarnation of this. Ansible Tower is now more evolved. There's more features with it. And is a fantastic platform to run all your automation from. So there's some more information on here, which you can go through. I'll link that one in the description as well. Now, if you don't want to pay for Ansible Tower, you can get something which is, let's move this out of the way again. So you can get something which is called Ansible AWX. So Ansible AWX. Now this is the open source, so this is free. This is open source. So this is the upstream version of the Ansible Automation Platform / old version Ansible Tower. So with AWX, you can have all the functionality, you can have the GUI, you can have the APIs, you can have the security, but this is free to use. So it's very easy to get started. I've got another page on Ansible AWX and how to install it. Let's just find that. Now this actually now runs in Kubernetes, so it's a little bit of a challenge to install it, but I do have a guide here which I've written. This is how to install Ansible AWX on Ubuntu 20 using Kubernetes. So you can see here, I run through exactly how to get that up and running. So there's a bit of work to do, but it's not too onerous, and you will end up with your own version of Ansible AWX, which is great. So that is the introduction to the Getting Started with Ansible video. Hopefully I've highlighted some of the terms, some of the key concepts, and then in the next videos in this series, I'm going to break down each of those one at a time. If you've enjoyed this, if you've got any questions, then please comment the questions below. I'll do my best to answer any questions that come up. And again, my name is Roger Perkin. I do have some Ansible training, so I'll link that as well. So there's some advanced courses that you can take. But the main thing is, I hope you enjoyed this video. Questions in the comments, and hit the subscribe button, and I look forward to seeing you in the next video. Thank you. Bye.